Details emerging tonight of a bizarre attack on North Korea's embassy in Spain and the U.S.-based activist accused of organizing it. CNN's Brian Todd has been working the story for us. Brian, lots of questions surrounding this case.
Wolf, this case just keeps getting more bizarre at every turn. Tonight, the alleged ringleader of that raid is being hunted by U.S. marshals. And for the first time, we're hearing a startling claim from that man's lawyer about why his team went into that North Korean embassy.
My name is Adrian Hong.
Tonight, Adrian Hong is on the run. His face is plastered on a U.S. Marshal's wanted poster, and he's allegedly armed and dangerous. Hong, who strangely uses the name Oswaldo Trump as an alias, is accused of being the mastermind behind the bizarre raid on North Korea's embassy in Madrid on February 22nd, according to court documents from prosecutors just unsealed in Los Angeles. U.S. and Spanish officials accused Hong and several others of breaking into the North Korean embassy using knives, iron bars, machetes, and fake guns. They tied up embassy staff members and beat them, court documents allege, before making off in embassy vehicles with a stash of thumb drives, hard drives, computers, and at least one cell phone. The North Koreans call it a grave terrorist attack. Spanish authorities have asked the U.S. to find and arrest Adrian Hong, but his lawyer tells CNN tonight the U.S. marshals aren't the only people hunting for him.
We know from credible sources that the North Korean government is seeking Adrian Hong and some of his associates from the provisional government of Free Joseon and is seeking to target them for assassination.
It is a brutal totalitarian regime ruled by a royal family.
The goal of Hong's group, the Provisional Government of Free Joseon, is to overthrow Kim Jong-un's regime. U.S. authorities raided Hong's apartment last month, but he wasn't there.
Police!
His lawyer says Hong is scared for his life and that he denies roughing up anyone at the North Korean embassy. He says they were invited into the embassy that day, and he points to these surveillance photos of another member of the group entering. Attorney Lee Walosky says members of the group had contact with someone at the embassy in the days before the incident. But why would members of a group which wants to overthrow Kim Jong-un be invited into that embassy?
It is there where the defections generally occur. It is individuals who are posted outside of North Korea who, when given the opportunity, will choose to defect.
So did they go to the embassy to help someone defect?
They have said that they were responding to an urgent situation in that embassy. And I really, you know, out of the concern for the safety of some people who may still be in that embassy, I would prefer to just leave my answer for now at that.
U.S. prosecutors now say Hong's group tried to get a top embassy official to defect, but, quote, he would not betray or desert his country. Still, analysts say Hong's group has succeeded in embarrassing the violent and vindictive North Korean dictator.
He would see it as a threat. I mean, he's assassinated or executed any number of senior officials that he saw or perceived to be a threat. So he would go after these members as much as he could.
Tonight, Hong's attorney is slamming the U.S. Justice Department for exercising warrants against Americans, he says, based on the accounts from North Korean officials. Justice officials promise the suspects will get due process. Wolf?
Right.